हाय, मैं अखिलेश कुमार पोटेंशियल टीम से। जैसा कि लॉकडाउन है और सब लोग अपने घर से काम कर रहे हैं, मैं भी अपने घर में रह के काम कर रहा हूँ। स्टूडियो जाना तो अभी मुश्किल है, और मैं जो इंस्टॉलेशन करने जा रहा हूँ, इसमें हमारे घर के कुछ सामान को यूज़ करके मैं एक इंस्टॉलेशन कर रहा हूँ। और जैसा कि मैं नेचर को लेकर काम करता हूँ, उसी सब्जेक्ट में मैं ये काम कर रहा हूँ।
हम सभी ने प्रकृति को टेकन फॉर ग्रांटेड ले लिया है। हम सब ने जब चाहा, जैसे चाहा, प्रकृति पे बोझ डालते गए। यह समय हम सभी के लिए अलार्मिंग है। अब ना रुके तो क्या होगा? ऐसे कई सवालों के साथ अब समय है बदलाव लाने का। घर पे रहिए और पृथ्वी रूपी घर को कैसे बचाया जाए सोचिए। पृथ्वी खुद आगे आ गई है अपना संतुलन बनाने के लिए। प्लीज घर पे रहिए, सुरक्षित रहिए।
Hi, my name is Sabyasachi and I am an artist, an educator and a writer. When I am not painting or amidst children, I am writing. I write to lesser-known destinations across India, primarily to ancient sites. I document the sculptures found at these places and study them. I am also writing a book on Indian iconography. Having said that, these days I pretty much like everyone else am grounded due to the corona menace that has disrupted our lives. On my way home before the quarantine deadline set in, while riding across Haryana and UP, I came across thousands of people walking their way out of most probably Ghaziabad or Delhi. I started my journey back home from Shimla to Agra, that's where my studio and residence is, at 4 a.m. in the morning. While I was climbing down the Chandigarh road, I crossed several construction workers with their families, babies in arms and sacks of belongings on their backs, navigating the dark road by the help of their mobile torch. Trust me, this miserable scene has been etched in my memory and I can't easily rub it off. What are we, the well-offs? What the hell were the ticketers doing, not helping the employees in distress? I seriously don't know. Then later in the day when I stopped for tea at a dhaba on the Yamuna Expressway, I came across 5 busloads of workers from Nepal. They were all in a rush to reach the Tanakpur border before the roadblocks went up. Did we bring this onto ourselves? Are we to blame for this epidemic? I don't know. These days, I feel absolutely confused. Anyway, I'm an outdoors person and staying within walls, and especially due to something not within our control, gets on my nerves. I'm used to riding across open spaces and exploring this vast country. I'm not a people's person, and this forced quarantine has made me see one aspect of life that I often slighted, the love of home. At least I have a home to get back to. I hope every migrant worker that I came across en route have what I have. Now, what does an artist do in such forced circumstances? Well, he paints. I have been painting frantically those faces that I met, their smiles, their chatter, their worries, and the sacks that held their belongings. I don't know how else I can capture this troubled moment. I hope we get over this blight and emerge as better beings. I don't know when we are going to learn. Also, I hope things really get better. I just don't know.
This is Chandra Mohan, Baroda based printmaker. Thank you for giving the opportunity to speak on COVID-19 effect. I made a portfolio of 10 works, each print in size 20 by 30 inch. Firstly, I would like to speak on my own experiences during the COVID-19 lockdown period. They could be a normal things, mostly all are experiencing, but I seriously prefer they are very valid points to me. During the lockdown early times, I use it to go on my bike for my daily essentials like grocery materials, vegetables and ATM to withdraw the money. But since last 2 weeks, the police rules are very strict at the Chani area where my studio located. With reason or sometime without sufficient reason, they are seizing the bikes. So as most of the people, I started to move outside by walk for vegetables, and also I use it to go to ATM, which is 2 kilometers far to my residency, by walk only. I hardly managing my studio rents and art materials, but along with that I have to pay money to my two of advocates for my two of unfortunate court cases 2007 and recent one in 2018. I don't know what going to happening in coming days and how to handle all things remained with big question mark. I hope that things will be come to normal as early as possible. Since my master's 2007, I have been working in woodcut is my primary medium. If I can talk something about my portfolio of work and medium of woodcut, hailing from a family of traditional carpenters, inspired and pushed my interest of using wood as natural material medium to explore the possibilities this medium can offer. I invented my own registration techniques on wood using hardwood for prints because hardwood has the possibilities of expressive bold lines, scratches and uneven patches. The fearless use of colors for the wood prints is also one of the signifying traits of my work, also with using vibrant colors into my printmaking practice. I claim to have an intimate relationship with the colors. In my work, I have incorporated bold saturated colors in a way that is visually overwhelming to the eye of the viewers. The image reveals the texture of the wood as well as the particular blend of intense colors. Indeed, it is only through the medium of woodcut and by using the medium in this particular way I have been achieved this effect. Apart from incorporating the meticulous techniques, I pay a lot of attention to the images, forms, subject matters in my prints, which mostly have symbolic effect. For example, body as a trope has been significant element in all my work so far. By showing the body, myself or others, sometimes in larger than life format, to able to reflect my inner state, my experience and my struggles onto paper. The subject matters of my work are mostly based on my everyday experiences in life. I carefully use certain pictorial tools in my work to express the subject matters better.
Hi, this is Kanchan Chandra, an artist from Delhi. I'm a painter, printmaker, and I do mixed medias. We are presently in a very grave and difficult, unusual situation and circumstances. When the lockdown started, I was constantly seeing images and videos in the news and on social medias. I was saddened. My heart came out when I saw visuals of laborers and daily wages walking for miles and miles with their family, with bundles on their head and dangling on the shoulders. They would just not stop. One particular image of a woman walking with her 3 kids, the younger one crying and a girl limping but still walking. That particular image kept haunting me for days. I was totally heartbroken, yet I admired their determination, willpower, and focus to reach their target. I just felt helpless. One could just pray. That's when I realized how fortunate we are to have food and a roof above us. And above all, that we are artists. Indulging ourselves in art keeps our sanity. At the same time, when I still see images of empty streets with dry fallen leaves suggesting spring is here and summer is soon approaching, I cannot but help think of HBO horror movies. It's so creepy and eerie. I do love solace and silence, but this silence and voidness is frightening and spine-chilling. Isolation is a gift. One should use it well. It's like nature is reminding us of how inhuman, self-centered and insensitive we had become as a human race. Nature is teaching us a lesson and reminding us to be human, compassionate, kind, and not indulge in violence. Maybe Corona is an answer to Mother Nature's balance to the ego of human beings. I cannot but help to think of a title I have very often kept for my artworks. Que sera, sera. Whatever will be, will be. The future's not ours to see. But here, I do hope that future shows us light. Usually, every year, I just disappear from the social and art world from mid-March onwards. I paint for 4-5 months without any interruption. It is actually my most productive time. Occasionally, I meet a friend and we spend time together over lazy lunch or I step out to meet them. Then I go for my early evening walks. But during this lockdown, my routine has been changed. With no house help, I'm doing the housework, cooking, then painting. So my day is quite full. And of course, I do manage to see movies on Netflix. I can't live without it. I do miss my walks in the park and the fresh air. But I do compensate by doing walks in my small balcony and inside the house. Right now, I'm finishing off the artworks I had to do for a few upcoming shows. I'm also doing a series of drawings on paper. They're mostly based on COVID-19 and lockdown and how it's leaving an impact on human beings. They are more symbolic. I'm sharing some works that I made earlier based on a common man. One is scared, uncertain of when this lockdown will end and normal life be back. I'm more concerned about all the common people who have returned to their villages and their life depends on totally daily wages. Being an artist, also it's a big question about the survival. As in recession and economical crisis, one of the first things to be affected is art and culture. Let's hope for the best, stay safe and indoors.
Hello everyone, I am Chandan Bezborua, a printmaker artist from Northeast Assam, India. From last almost 10 years, I am living and working in Delhi NCR. I have my own studio here and my studio is on the upper story, just above my house. So during this lockdown period, I can easily go to my studio and continue my work. I want to work with all medium, but mostly I'm working in printmaking only. From last 3 to 4 years, I concentrate with the medium of woodcut. At the beginning of this pandemic circumstances, yes, I was scared too, could not concentrate on my work and stop working. Then I realized that only work can make me happier and I have to overcome this situation with my creative work. Then again, I started working on my ongoing series somewhere in Northeast India on woodcut block, taking editions during the daytime only and reading an Assamese historical novel Makan by Dr. Rita Chaudhary at night, chatting with friends and family members along with the other necessary household works. I always wake up from bed with a smile and give my thanks to God and do some yoga asanas. I love to see Ramayana, Bomkesh Bakshi and Jungle Book. I'm working in DPS as a fine art teacher. My principal asked me to do some work for school magazine on this pandemic coronavirus. I did few drawings with watercolor and still working on the same. My ongoing series is somewhere in Northeast India and which have its two different parts. I try to innovate and experiment in printmaking medium, which is traditional but also an unconventional one. I started printmaking early in my career. While I was in a Government College of Art and Craft, Guwahati in 1995 to 2000, MFA in printmaking from Vishwabharati University, Shantiniketan during 2001 to 2003. I make my own woodcut prints from my own digital photographs. During image making with carving tools, I go through my experience of self-attachment with the particular frame and between the surface itself. It's all about that atmospheric emotional interpretation transforming on wood through wood carving tools, or one can say through expression and visualization. Landscape, which have been ignored by urbanizations, at least we have to think and start working on it as we learn from natural disasters. As I am very conscious about the originality of the reality, it takes a long time to complete. From photographic realistic approach, I go through my own imagination and skill along with the photographic digitalized modern technology. My own involvement and its spontaneous activities with the landscape, its handmade aspect of during cutting, but not only the reinterpretation of the photograph. The technique has its wide range of possibilities on woodcut medium. As a result, the digital culture, I experiment with its new dimension and perspective in Indian contemporary printmaking. I have learned a lot during this panic circumstances. Meaning of life with happiness only. Be happy and make others happy. Spread love and help. Value of family, value of nature, and also value of materialistic world. Simple living and high thinking. I want to finish with the song of Dr. Bhupen Hazarika. Gum 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 meghe gorojile, gum 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 dhumuha ahile, jibon dinga bai thaka bandho he, gobhir nodit kumbhir ase, kumbhiraru moron ase, bahut tumar bol ase, hezar hatir khah ase, hoy hongkus era bandho he, jibon dinga bai thaka bandho he.
Namaste, my name is Nikhil Purohit. I'm an artist, art educator and archivist based in Mumbai. In these times when we are all locked down, what can we do? Perhaps we could be thinking about extending our reach to the arts pedagogy in the local languages. That is extremely necessary aspect of art and its production. I use this opportunity of lockdown and Evilo channel to make an appeal to the art community, especially the art educators. The theoretical exposure of the students from regional art schools is highly limited due to the lack of reading material in local languages. Most art discourses are conducted in English, where the primary entry to the world of art-based knowledge is reserved only to the able English-speaking students and artists who mostly reside in the urban and metropolitan environments. The need for discourse in the vernacular is not only to have a fair exposure to art history, but to encourage indigenous sensibilities and practices under the local global cultural setup. Further, also to contribute to the regional perspectives on art history, the discourse is necessary. The language is observed to have become a wall opaque enough to promote monocultures that are unsustainable in long run. I have worked with students from regional belonging long enough to state that what seems basic and rudimentary in a sense to the contemporary art field is not even a desirable knowledge to them. Ironically, the students too are highly ignorant and hesitant to access the information without difficulty available on the internet and social media even though they have access to smart digital devices. I am aware that the subject matter is too convoluted to state it here in few words, and rather, I urge everyone listening to this audio piece to start using the time and situation to bring about a variation in the attitude for art education through technology. Please organize live streaming or closed circuit conferences, reading sessions, artwork discussions, portfolio interactions with or for the students who have internet access in the regional language. The topics could be wide ranging and can be about art history, aesthetics, design thinking, semiotics, current trends in art field, etc., etc. One can simply conduct virtual guided tours of museums on Google Arts and Culture Project in regional languages, share artists' own works in their language. I have been working towards bilingual discourses for some time now, and currently with the help of some colleagues setting up a new channel trial to streamline the modes of interaction. Therefore, I make my appeal in three regional languages I know. नमस्ते। दृश्य कला और सिद्धांतों के पढ़ाने वाले शिक्षक और कलाकारों को मैं विनयपूर्वक अनुरोध करना चाहूँगा कि इस लॉकडाउन के परिस्थिति का उपयोग करके आप अपनी भाषा में इंटरनेट के जरिए इंस्टाग्राम लाइव, फेसबुक लाइव, यूट्यूब जैसे माध्यमों का इस्तेमाल कर अंग्रेजी ना समझने वाले छात्रों को कला इतिहास, विभिन्न सिद्धांत, समकालीन कला के चर्चा सत्र, ऑनलाइन म्यूजियम के सूचना सहित फेरे या चुनिंदा कलाकृतियां या लेखों का वाचन ऐसे और तत्सम उपक्रम करें। वो छात्र जिनके पास इंटरनेट तो है पर भाषा के अड़चन से सही जानकारी नहीं पा सकते, उनको घर बैठे अध्ययन का मौका मिलेगा और स्थानीय कला संवेदना को बढ़ावा मिलेगा। आशा करता हूं कि आप मेरे इस अनुरोध का आदर करेंगे और कुछ उपक्रम वास्तव में करेंगे। धन्यवाद। आपका जिज्ञासु निखिल पुरोहित। कलेचे इतिहास आणि सिद्धांत हे विषय शिकवणारे शिक्षक आणि कलाकार यांना मी सविनय आग्रह करतो की या लॉकडाऊनच्या काळाचा सदुपयोग करून इंस्टाग्राम, झूम, फेसबुक लाईव्ह, यूट्यूब इत्यादी माध्यमांचा वापर करून इंग्रजी तितकीशी नीट न समजणारे पण उत्सुक व जिज्ञासू विद्यार्थ्यांसाठी ऑनलाईन संवाद साधावा। चर्चासत्र, लेक्चर, वस्तुसंग्रहालयांची ऑनलाईन सहल, विशिष्ट कलाकृतींची चर्चा, समकालीन कलाक्षेत्रातील घडामोडींबद्दल सोप्या भाषेत चर्चा घडून आणल्याने मोबाईल आणि इंटरनेट उपलब्ध असलेले ग्रामीण, निमशहरी किंवा शहरातील कला उत्सुक विद्यार्थ्यांना खूप मोठी पर्वणीच असेल। आपण ह्याविषयी हालचाल कराल आणि उपक्रम काही ना काहीतरी घडून आणाल अशी आशा आहे। धन्यवाद। आपला जिज्ञासु निखिल पुरोहित। ಚಿತ್ರಕಲೆ ಇತಿಹಾಸ ಮತ್ತು ಸಿದ್ಧಾಂತಗಳನ್ನು ಕಲಿಸುವ ಶಿಕ್ಷಕರಿಗೆ ಹಾಗೂ ಕಲಾವಿದರಿಗೆ ನಾನು ಮಾಡುವ ವಿನಯಪೂರ್ವಕ ಆಗ್ರಹ, ಈ ಲಾಕ್ಡೌನ್ ಪರಿಸ್ಥಿತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಭಾಷೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ವಿವಿಧ ಇಂಟರ್ನೆಟ್ ಮಾಧ್ಯಮದ ಮೂಲಕ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಲೈವ್, ಫೇಸ್ಬುಕ್ ಲೈವ್, ಯೂಟ್ಯೂಬ್ಗಳಂತಹ ಮಾಧ್ಯಮವನ್ನು ಉಪಯೋಗಿಸಿ ಕಲಾ ಇತಿಹಾಸವಾಗಲಿ ನಿಮಗೆ ಹಿಡಿಸುವಂತಹ ಸಿದ್ಧಾಂತಗಳನ್ನು ಆನ್ಲೈನ್ ಚರ್ಚೆ ಮಾಡಿದರೆ ಮೊಬೈಲ್ ಮತ್ತು ಇಂಟರ್ನೆಟ್ ಉಪಲಬ್ಧವಿದ್ದ ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿಗಳು ಈ ಒಂದು ಚಟುವಟಿಕೆಯಿಂದ ಲಾಭ ಪಡೆಯಬಹುದು. ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಅಲ್ಲದೆ ಥಿಯರಿ ವಿಷಯಗಳ ಮಹತ್ವವೂ ತಿಳಿದು ಆ ದಿಶೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಹೆಚ್ಚು ಅಭ್ಯಾಸ ಮಾಡತೊಡಗಬಹುದು. ಇದರಿಂದ ಸ್ಥಾನಿಕ ಕಲಾ ನಿರ್ಮಿತಿಯ ಪದ್ಧತಿಗಳು ಬದಲಾವಣೆಯಾಗಿ ನವನಿರ್ಮಿತಿಗೆ ಕಾರಣರಾಗಬಹುದು. ನೀವು ಈ ವಿನಂತಿಯನ್ನು ಸ್ವೀಕರಿಸಿ ಕೃತಿ ಮಾಡುವರೆಂದು ಅಭಿಲಾಷೆ ಇದ್ದೇನೆ. ಧನ್ಯವಾದಗಳು. ಜಿಜ್ಞಾಸು ನಿಖಿಲ್ ಪುರೋಹಿತ್.
मेरा हिंदी बहुत खराब है।